This is Guayanas. It's part of a rapidly growing system of National Marine Conservation Areas, or NMCAs, across Canada. The protections provided by an NMCA make Guayanas a refuge where biodiversity, ecosystems, and people can all thrive together. They protect cultural practices and resources too. What makes these waters different from some other protected places is that they're managed not just by the government of Canada, but together with the Haida Nation. Also, people here can continue to earn a living from things like sustainable fishing and other commercial activities inside the conservation area. The protections of the NMCA make sure that these things happen in a way that keeps ecosystems balanced and healthy. Now, it's important to know that the Haida Nation has been stewarding these lands and waters since time immemorial. They designated Guayanas as a Haida Heritage Site back in the 80s, and the federal government then followed with the co-creation of the National Marine Conservation Area Reserve in 2010. Guayanas is an example of how governments at all levels can work together to strengthen marine protection. At Parks Canada, we want to keep working with people who are already connected to Canada's waters to create more of these NMCAs. 10 more, to be exact. This is Parks Canada marine ecologist Deanne Blanchard. She's been working hard behind the scenes with community partners for years now to establish these new NMCAs.
Maintenir des écosystèmes en santé à l'intérieur des aires marines nationales de conservation, c'est important pour tous. Les océans nous apportent énormément au quotidien. La plus grande partie de l'oxygène que nous respirons provient des océans. Elle est produite par des micro-organismes qu'on appelle du phytoplancton. C'est des mini-algues qui flottent à la surface des océans. Et une respiration sur deux provient des océans.
Aside from being important for humans in general, NMCAs also protect major habitats for lots of species at risk. Yep, that's a narwhal. They also support indigenous rights and traditional harvesting practices, which is a vital means of access to healthy, sustainable food sources and is essential to indigenous cultures. These are just some of the many reasons we're working with partners to create more NMCAs.
I'm really happy to be part of this project because it allows me to get reconnected back to the land, to the waters of the area where I grew up in. The Meshkego people have always lived in harmony with the earth and with all living things within the earth. And they often talk about the interconnectivity between the land and the water, that there is not a line between, there's actually just a continuation.
Canada's oceans and Great Lakes have supported Indigenous and coastal communities for centuries, and they continue to be hugely important to people who are connected to these marine areas. So we know why protecting waters, along with the ecosystems, biodiversity, and people that they support, is important. And that's especially true for Canada. We actually have the longest coastline of any country. We're also responsible for around 20% of the world's fresh water. No pressure. Canada's goal is to protect 30% of its waters by 2030, otherwise referred to as 30 by 30. That's nearly 3 million kilometers squared of protected water, which is more than 36 times the size of Lake Superior. That's a lot of H2O. At Parks Canada, collaborating with Indigenous governments and coastal communities to create new National Marine Conservation Areas is our way of contributing to that goal. And like we said, we're planning for 10 new ones. This is really exciting news. Well, we're excited anyway. Our aim is to have one NMCA to represent each of Canada's 29 unique marine regions. These areas are hand-picked to showcase the huge diversity of marine and freshwater habitats that Canada has to offer, and important cultural and historical features too. By integrating Indigenous leadership in the creation and management of NMCAs, we can make sure this work is grounded in Western science, Indigenous knowledge, and other local perspectives. Establishing new national marine conservation areas takes time, but when everything falls into place, they're an exciting blueprint for a future where we work together to protect and manage Canada's waters in a way that benefits both people and the planet. Follow along on our journey to more NMCAs at the link on your screen.